Hi, my name is Pastor Conrad Vine, and welcome to what is our last edition of Grace and Grit, our daily devotional for you, our wider AFM family, as we journey through this pandemic together. As we've gone through this pandemic, we've gone through different stages. We've gone through the initial shock of the virus arriving in our countries and our own communities. We've gone through the uncertainty when lockdowns are announced and daily life screeches to a halt. We've gone through the mad scramble of rearranging our work lives and our school lives and our personal lives to cope with the lockdowns. We've gone through a whole range of what are often very negative emotions, fear and foreboding, anxiety and anger, dread and despair. But now, by the grace of God, we see that all around the world, the lockdowns are slowly being eased. We are slowly being allowed to leave our homes more and more and go to places where we normally went every day, maybe to our places of work. Schools are now being opened in some parts of the world. It is possible to travel outside of your home state to neighboring states. Now, physically, things may look the same as we come to this end of the lockdown, but I believe the world has changed in many ways, not just economically, but we have changed politically and we have also changed socially. So is there anything in the Word of God we find that could give us guidance and comfort as we emerge from our homes into the post-lockdown world? Well, there is actually. It's one of my favorite stories in the Bible, and it's found in Joshua chapter 1. This is the story of God revealing himself to Joshua, who is about to lead the people of Israel across the River Jordan and into the Promised Land. He is entering a new country, a new world, where there are different expectations. There are three beautiful promises found in Joshua chapter 1 and the first 12 verses. I just want to reflect with you on those three beautiful promises today. The first of those promises is this: step out in faith, I will be with you. This is what the Word of God says. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord spoke to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' assistant, saying, "My servant Moses is dead. Now proceed to cross the Jordan, you and all this people, into the land that I am giving them to the Israelites." From his years as a slave in Egypt, Moses was the only leader that Joshua had ever known. Joshua had faithfully supported Moses for 40 years in the wilderness, lifting his hands in battle, serving as one of the 12 spies, and obeying the often unpopular decisions of Moses. But now Moses was gone, and Joshua was moving from the known to the unknown, from the comfortable to the uncomfortable, from the familiar to the strange. We might say he was emerging from his lockdown in the wilderness. And no longer could Joshua look to Moses when the tough decisions needed to be made. Spiritual leadership is a physical burden, it is an emotional burden, and it is a mental burden. Both Moses and Joshua had served 40-year apprenticeships before they were ready to lead God's people. And entering this new world, God knew that his servant needed encouragement. And so God encourages him with his beautiful promise found in verse 9. "I hereby command you, be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened or dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." And as we emerge from our lockdown in our countries and in our homes and in our states and in our communities, like Joshua, we need the assurance that God will be with us wherever we go. The second promise that I really value within this story of Joshua and his encounter with God is found in verse 8. This is what the verse says. "This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth. You shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to act in accordance with all that is written in it. For then you shall make your way prosperous, and you shall be successful." This is the promise: meditate on my word, and I will guide you. What a beautiful promise. The purpose of meditation in the Bible is to move us from an intellectual knowledge of what the Bible says to understanding how to apply the word of God within our lives. When we consider everything the Bible says about meditation on the Word of God, it involves a conscious and deliberate reflection upon God's revelation of himself in Scripture, in nature, in salvation, and in personal history. Meditation involves the conscious memorization and the speaking forth, the vocalization of the Word of God. And it is associated in the Bible with a circumspect life, that is, a life that is looking to avoid any known sins. As we prepare to leave our lockdowns and enter what is a changed world, like Joshua, we need the assurance and the promise from God that He will guide us as we open ourselves to His Spirit through meditating upon His Word. So the first promise is this: step out in faith, I will be with you. The second promise is this: meditate on my word, I will guide you. And the third promise is this: follow my leading and I will bless you. We find that in verse 9, which says, I hereby command you, be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened or dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Joshua indeed did step out in faith, confident of God's abiding presence. Joshua indeed meditated on God's word, confident of God's personal guidance. And indeed, Joshua followed the leading of God across the River Jordan, through the Battle of Jericho and Ai, to the conquest of the Promised Land. And God did indeed bless Joshua and all the people of Israel. Every tribe received their promised inheritance. At the end of his life, Joshua's testimony to God's faithfulness is incredibly beautiful. This is what he says in chapter 23. You have seen all that the Lord your God has done to all these nations for your sake, for it is the Lord your God who has fought for you. And now I am about to go the way of all the earth. And you know in your hearts and souls, all of you, that not one thing has failed of all the good things that the Lord your God promised concerning you. All have come to pass for you, not one of them has failed. He gave the same charge to the next generation that he had received from God. Like Joshua, we are also invited to follow God's leading into this new world, this post-pandemic world, confident that as we follow God's leading, He will bless us abundantly. So this is really the end of our last Grace and Grit devotional for you, our wider AFM family. It's been a privilege to share with you and with our AFM team a series of devotionals to encourage you and, by God's grace, be a blessing as we've journeyed through this pandemic together. As we close off this series, I want to encourage you with these three beautiful promises that we find in Joshua chapter 1. Number 1, step out in faith, I will be with you. Number 2, meditate on my word, I will guide you. And number 3, follow my leading and I will bless you. It's my prayer that when we get to heaven and we gather around that messianic banquet, we will be able to echo the words of Joshua in chapter 23 and verse 14. Beautiful testimony of God's goodness. This is what he says. We know in our hearts and souls, all of us, that not one thing has failed of all the good things that the Lord our God promised concerning us. All have come to pass. Not one of them has failed. So my friends, my brothers and sisters of the wider AFM family, step out in faith. God will be with you. Meditate on His word, God will guide you. Follow His leading, and God will bless you. May our experience be the same as Joshua's, and one day when we gather together, may each one of us have a testimony of how God led us and guided us and blessed us in the midst of this post-pandemic world. Until we meet again, may God be with us all. Amen. Our dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank you that the lockdowns are beginning to ease, and that in your mercy we can start to re-emerge, to re-engage with our daily lives. Father, we do so with very mixed emotions. Many of us are experiencing a sense of fear. Lord, many of us are immunocompromised. We're carrying health challenges that we know make us vulnerable to this virus. Father, many of us are eager to get on with our old lives. But Lord, the truth is that our world has changed. Lord, we've changed politically, we've changed economically, we've changed sociologically, and Lord, many of us have changed personally. Father, we've said goodbye to loved ones. We've seen businesses go down the drain. We've seen our life savings evaporate. Father, we are very different people to those who entered the pandemic at the start of 2020. Lord, as we step out into this new world, we want to claim those promises that you gave Joshua. Step out in faith, and I will be with you. Meditate on my word, and I will guide you. Follow my leading, and I will bless you. Father, give us the courage indeed to step out in faith. Father, give us the intentionality and the time to meditate upon your word. And Father, give us the wisdom and the discernment to sense where your spirit is leading, that we may indeed follow you. And I pray, Father, that when we get to heaven, each one of us will have a tale to tell, not just that we came through a lockdown, but of how you led each one of us out of this lockdown into a new world with a new life, with, Father, a new focus on ministry. Father, pain and suffering has an incredible way of rearranging our priorities. I ask you, Father, that my priorities, that all of our priorities, would have been divinely reordered as a result of this pandemic. That our focus from now on will exclusively be on the salvation of your children around the world. And so, Father, until we as a body meet together, brothers and sisters around the world, I ask that you will be with us, that you will guide us, and that you will bless us. And until Jesus comes again, Father, may we be found faithful in whatever portion of the vineyard you have called us and equipped us to serve in. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Somewhere on this earth, in the heart of a foreign land, family with a passion is living their mission plan, bringing God's truth to a hungry, thirsty tribe, knowing well their lives are always on the line. Missionaries need missionaries too. They need the prayers of loved ones, they need love from me and you. And when they just like Christ make the ultimate sacrifice, someday in heaven they'll thank you, 'cause you're a missionary too. Someday in heaven they'll thank you for the things your prayers brought them through, and your mission is accomplished. Oh, thank you, you're a missionary too. You're a missionary too. You're a missionary too.